My name is Erik Goka. I'm in the laboratory of Dr. Marc Lippman. We do breast cancer research here, and I am a recent graduate of the cancer biology PhD program here at the University of Miami. So the focus of my research in this lab is we were looking for genes that can cooperate with HER2-NU, and HER2 is a known driver of breast cancer. Research in the past decade or two has allowed the development of a number of drugs that target this particular driver of breast cancer. The thing that I like most about working in the lab is the ability to satisfy my curiosity, mainly. You know, every day you come in to the lab and you have questions, and it's up to you to try to address these questions through a series of experiments. I was born in Los Angeles, California, and I grew up in San Diego. While I didn't have the privilege of meeting my grandmother, who died of breast cancer, it did influence my decision to go into cancer research. In school, you learn about normal biology, and you learn about how things work and how they're supposed to be working. But in the cancer context, everything gets thrown out the window. It's not about how things work, it's how they don't work or how they don't function properly. And this was very interesting to me. When you think about science or medicine, you know, you don't get a whole lot of exposure to the research side, at least not at a high school level. And I didn't really know about it. It wasn't until I actively started doing research in academic research labs where I got exposure to what it is that we do here. You know, instead of reading a textbook and trying to figure something out, you can actually just perform experiments and see if you're right or wrong. I had a friend that was working in an academic research lab, and he told me about it, and I thought that, you know, this would be a good experience. When I was there, you know, I would do everything from dishwashing to, you know, cleaning up after the graduate students. And then, you know, having that foundation, you realize and you appreciate, you know, what other people do for you when you get into the situation when you are a graduate student. So it looks like our experiment worked. What we did is we transfected in some ampicillin-resistant cDNA into these bacteria. The complex nature of cancer itself is one of the largest challenges that we face. Luckily, in this day and age, with advances in technology, I feel that we might be closer and closer to hopefully finding a cure. The thing that fascinates me about my research the most is that it's my research. When you get data that is interesting and compelling, you might be the only one on the face of the earth that knows this data. I find that very interesting, you know, and it's something that you just build upon. Hopefully in the foreseeable future, we will have successfully developed a drug, tested it in our preclinical models, and we'll have a drug in the clinic that cures breast cancer patients. The one thing I can say to people that are aspiring young scientists is that, you know, it's always good to be a dreamer. So it always helps to have an open mind, but a prepared mind. And if you have those things, you'll be able to achieve anything that you want. Thank you.